I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart I have but one desire, and that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of being complete. I don't set the world.
War. War never changes. Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything from God to justice to simple psychotic rage.
time.
Thank you.
Well, hi there. Welcome to Andale. I'm Willie Wilson, though folks just call me Bill. Is there anything I can do for you? I feed my family and I love my wife and daughter. What else more is there to life, stranger? Family first. And any man who says anything different is saying something wrong. And you should hit that man with a stick. Why, it's a place to settle down and raise a family. Of course, we don't just let anyone in here. The Homeowners Association is very clear on that. Besides, there's no room, as amazing as Andale is. Is it any wonder that all the houses would be full of happy families?
You're new here, aren't you? Wow. I've never got a chance to talk to the new people. Dad always takes care of them, before I get a chance. It's okay, I guess. There aren't a lot of kids around here, and no one who comes to visit stays around long. Dad says it could be worse, that there are a lot of starving kids in other places. But still, I wish I had more kids to play with. The same things that all parents do. My mom cooks and cleans the house, and my dad goes to work with Mr. Wilson. They work in the basement, or sometimes in Mr. Wilson's shed. Dad says that when I'm older, I'll come to work with him, and we're in the family business. It's swell, except I wish there were more kids, and my dad says I'm gonna have to marry smelly old Jenny Wilson someday. He keeps saying stuff to my mom about keeping the family going, and how when him and Mr. Wilson were brothers, they didn't want to get married. It's weird. That means Mr. Wilson is my uncle and Jenny is something. I don't know. It seems weird to marry her.
Good to see you.
Why, hello there. I heard there was someone new coming. How can our little family help you? Are you joking? It's fantastic here. The best town in the USA. Has been for, why, it's been so many years running that I've lost count. Oh, well, no one ever asks me my opinion about anything, but I love it here.
What's up?
Daddy can help you. I'm just a kid, you know.
Evening.
Welcome to Andale. It's a fine day, isn't it? Well, hello. Welcome to Andale, winner of the Best Town in the USA contest. Well, I don't right know. But we're the best one, isn't that what matters? I mean, we're the winners, us. Not Springfield, not Rockville, us. So like I was saying, welcome to Andale. What can the Smith family do for you? It's the best little town there is. We don't have a care in the world here. I mean, honestly, what more do you need to know? Really?
Well, hello there. Hello there, stranger. Good to meet you. Name's Jack Smith. I hear you've already met my wife. Sweet lady, isn't she? But anyway, welcome to Andale, the best little town in Virginia. Not here, not in Andale, no ma'am. The great Commonwealth of Virginia is alive and well. In fact, we just voted ourselves a new governor. The adults walked right on down to the polling location and dropped ballots into the box. How do you think it works? Yes, sir, it's every American's civic duty to cast his vote for his favorite Republican candidate. Am I right? Yes, sir, democracy is God's best gift. Right after family, of course. Now, my vote is my business and no one else's. But I'll tell you one thing. We didn't vote for any beatnik liberal commies, that's for sure. And it's good to meet you, too. Feel free to stay in Andale as long as you like. Heck, stop by the house for dinner sometime if you'd like. Just let Linda know beforehand so she can make enough for four. I hope to see you there. So, did you need anything else? I work to feed my family just like every red-blooded American man should. Why, a man that can't keep his family fed isn't any kind of man at all. No, sir. Andale, greatest place there is. We win Town of the Year every year. We've got no end of food and no troubles at all. Yep, there's no better place to raise a family. Tamper with that and we're gonna have a problem.
What?
Glorious day, isn't it?
Good to see you.
What? Who are you? What? How? How did you get in here? What are you doing in this town? Get out! Get out while you can! What's wrong? You don't see anything wrong with a quiet little town full of friendly people in the middle of a blasted wasteland? And you're right sensible, too. Especially around here. The friendly neighbor bit is just an act. These people are stone-cold killers. Get out while you can. Just get as far away from here as possible. They're crazy! Crazy, I tell you!
Hey there, stranger. I got something I want to talk to you about. I couldn't help but notice that you were poking around in Bill's shed. So, did you find what you were looking for in there? You're right, it sure would have. You know, you're a breath of fresh air. Every time someone discovers our little secret, we have to hear about it. It's always, oh, how can you do this? Or, you're such terrible people. Or, please not me, I have a kid in Rivet City. Well, I have kids too. Family first, that's the way it works in Andale. From the day that the first four families decided to stay here. You're not bad, stranger. Stop on by any time and ask. That's a fine day, isn't it?
Oh man, I'm so jealous. You get to go out and do stuff outside of town, and you probably don't even have a bedtime.
Well,
afternoon, friend. I'll tell Linda and
come to Andale.
Good to see you.
I've heard of you. You're one of the good guys. Hi there, miss. Can I help you with something?
Are you crazy? Get out of here! I saw what happened out there, stranger. Those people may have been my family, but it had to be done. I was like them for so many years. I can't even talk about it. The only thing I can do is try to raise these kids and make Andale into a decent place. They'll stay here with me and I'll raise them myself. It's a shame that they have to grow up without their parents. But to tell you the truth, it's a lot better than growing up with their parents, everything considered. Better an orphan than a cannibal, I guess? We'll do our best is what we'll do. Me and the kids here in Andale. What's left of it, anyway. It'll be hard going, but we'll do the best we can. I just hope that one day these kids will grow up to do some good for this place after all the evil that's been done here. Sure did. Can't say that I'm proud of it, though. It was all just normal. It's what we all did. I didn't ever think much about it. I married Gladys, just like every boy in Andale married the girl closest to his age. We had Linda, and she grew up to marry Jack. It wasn't until Gladys died that I thought about what went on around here. So many people over the years, hundreds, thousands maybe. But what could I do? I'm just an old man. But you ended it. Bless you.
I'm not really sure what happened. Mr. Harris said that our parents went away, and they won't be back. He says that he'll tell me more about it when I'm older, but I miss my mom and dad.
Are you really from the wasteland?
My number of the passcode was 7, right?
Sierra Petrovna's the name. Good to see a new face in Girder Shade. I take it you're here to check out my Nuka-Cola collection and take the tour. Well, come on then. Let me show you around. But no free Nuka-Cola until the end of the tour. When Nuka-Cola was invented by John Caleb Braverton in 2044, it quickly became the world's most popular soft drink. The Wonder Drink soon drew a dedicated following, which prompted the Nuka-Cola Corporation to release many promotional items like these. By 2067, a Nuka-Cola machine such as this rare, pristine model could be found on almost every street in America. Even in today's crazy world, Nuka-Cola is still the number one choice of refreshment among Armageddon survivors. As promised, here's a little pick-me-up. An ice-cold Nuka-Cola. Just look at the frost on the bottle. So cold and delicious. Pardon me. I tend to lose myself when I hold on to a Nuka-Cola. Before I get to the little proposition I have for you, let me tell you a little bit about Nuka-Cola Quantum. Well, right before the bombs fell, the good folks at Nuka-Cola developed what they hoped was an improvement on the original formula. Calling it Nuka-Cola Quantum, it was said to have twice the calories, twice the carbohydrates, twice the caffeine, and twice the taste. Well, the flavor certainly wasn't the issue. The public was just split on the unique feature of the Quantum's appearance. You see, to make it stand out on store shelves and to give it that extra kick, the formula called for a mild isotope. The effect was a drink that not only boosted your energy, but also glowed with a bright blue light. Oh no, only ever so mildly. No ill effects were ever recorded. Well, it does have the unique property of making your pee glow. I love the stuff! I can't get enough of it! I thought I was hooked on regular Nuka-Cola, but the Quantum beats it by a long shot. I've got to have more! That's right. You bring me Nuka-Cola Quantum, and I pay you. Handsomely, I might add. For every bottle you bring me, I pay you some caps. You know, for expenses. But if you're super cool and find like enough bottles to fill my Nuka-Cola machine, 30 in all, I've got a super secret cool prize for you. Oh, okay. I have a schematic for the Nuka grenade. The only one in the whole capital wasteland. Bring me the bottles, and it's yours. Imagine the look on the target's face when they are burning alive in an effervescent explosion of cola and fruit flavors. So, what do you say? Will you bring me the bottles? Oh, goody! I can taste the Quantum already. Good luck to you, sweetie. In fact, I do. Surprised you, didn't I? Your best bet would be to find the ruins of the DC Nuka-Cola bottling facility. Find the shipping manifests inside. With them in hand, you should have a good clue as to where the quantum was delivered. While you're there, you may even be able to find some bottles of quantum. Yay! I knew I could count on you! I promised to put them to good use. Hey, anything I can do to help? Just ask.
So, who might you be and what brings you out to our little paradise? That's all, huh? It better be. Because I warn you, I don't like anyone messing around with my woman. Well, that's likely because it's none of anyone's business but ours. But hey, she's a fine-looking lady. I mean, you're no slouch either, but a man has his standards, you know. Wow, you are as naive as you look. How do I put it? I'd love to do the horizontal bop with her, you know, plow her bean field. Come on, kid. New to this stuff, huh, kid? Well, let's just say that she has something I want to get a hold of. That's where you enter the picture. I know she's asked you to find her some Nuka-Cola quantum. Heck, she asks everyone that wanders through here. What I'm proposing is you still look for the drinks, but instead of bringing it to her, you bring it to me. She'll be so impressed that I got all the Nuka-Cola for her, she'll melt in my arms like butter. I pay you the same she was going to pay, and everyone's happy. Holy shit! Are you for real? Hell yeah! I'm off to find you some quantum then, and I know right where to go.
time to talk to your type, local.
Do not interfere with security operations.
Hey, who are you? Right. What do you want? Well, you can never be too careful. Be warned, it's not safe here. Super mutants have attacked recently and carried off some of our friends. Come in, just don't cause any trouble, okay? A visitor? Who'd want to visit this hellhole? I'll bet you're here to rape and pillage us, aren't you? Aren't you? Not that it matters. We're all super mutant snacks anyway. The only thing you need to know is that we're all doomed. Sooner or later, they'll get every last one of us. What are you supposed to be anyway? Some kind of hero here to rescue our friends from the muties? Bah! You're just here to cause trouble. They took him north to that old police station in Germantown. No use in going up there, though. They've already been eaten, or worse, by now. Why? You thinking about performing a miracle and rescuing their sorry butts? Just what I thought. You're a mercenary. We don't need you. Go on up there to die if you like, but don't say you're doing it for us. They're out there. I can feel it. Don't think you'll scare anyone here. You could shoot down everyone in town and I wouldn't flinch. You live in big town, you learn to accept death. Two very angry types of movements. Slow, lumbering, powerful movements, and jerky, erratic, excitable movements. Both coming for the kill. There was a super mutant attack recently, and where there's one big ugly, then the slavers will come and pick off what's left of your carcass and drag. Skulk up toward Germantown near the. There isn't anything here that hasn't been destroyed or dragged away.
Of your own blood.
Quick! Unlock the door! You've got to get this door unlocked! You can't leave me here! You're rescuing me? Well, I think the others are dead. Me too. I'm extremely lucky you came along. Everyone else is dead. We're taken away. Well, except maybe for Shorty. But I'm not waiting around for some soup. There's a back door somewhere around here. If you're not back soon, I'm leaving without you. If I'm not here when you come back, meet me.
just escape me?
Thanks. Who are you? Yuli? Oh. Hell yeah!
We can talk back at Big Town.
Here to help me out again?
Our heroine returns!
What? Did she rescue them?
I'm glad to be safely back home. Right, of course. Rescuing... Well, I guess you can have this. I know you've already risked your life once already. But I heard the mutants talk. Really? Great.
But I count for something? She rescued me, at least.
And you waiting to learn something. Well,
go on. I'm paying attention. Show us what to do.
To be doing. Can you show me?
Well, Hotshot, are you going to teach us something or just stand there looking stupid?
They're coming!
Thank you.
Hey there.
Still alive?
We did it! You did it! You helped us defeat the mutants! Thanks again.
Yay!
I think I'm going to build a little shrine to you. All I need is some... Oh yeah? What is it? Not that I care what you think. Really? I mean, good. No one wants to look like the boring slobs in this town anyway. Besides, if we're all going to die here, I at least want my corpse to look better than these inane wastelanders. You're not, seeing anyone right now, are you? Well, I need to get going, but come back and visit me sometime, okay?
Die!
I'm starting to feel safe for the first time in a long time, thanks to you.
Remember to keep an eye on the north.
Watch the wastes.
Good to see you.
Hey.
It appears you've been